AKPF number one.
I am the cheese. I am the best character on the show. I am better than both the salami and the bologna combined.
Notice the texture of this meatloaf, and the pineapples give it a festive color.
Is that enough?
He's dropping F-bombs over
here. Don't look over here, meatwad.
I am the cheese. I am the best character on the show. I am better than both the salami and the bologna combined. I am the best character on the...
The meatloaf should be spongy, yet firm.
AKPF number one.
Embrace it.
So, what'd you think?
And now, an official newscast by the official teleprint of the Democratic People's Republic of Keene.
AKPF number one.
It's degrading garbage. Its confused social morals and disturbing undertones are tormenting the youth of our nation. Kids everywhere are mindlessly imitating
AKPF
antics. In Garberville, California. In Ogallala, Nebraska. For gosh sakes, we've got to stop the carnage.
Today is International Film Festival and the Knock Knock Day. I noticed they've cleared a lot of the chalking, so I figured I'd put some back. With the way whoever has smeared it out, it's like created a nice blue backing.
Rescued by Fred Parcell. That's sneaky.
Is Fred going to be joining us today?
Fred, like Parcells?
Oh.
Oh, that would be interesting.
Oh, is he doing the, Oh, this I gotta see. You can keep with Jane. I'll watch Fred remove. And he's off. Is that what cleaning up after he means, the chalk? They have him doing that?
Oh, that's pretty...
It's pretty funny because one time I was chalking in front of City Hall and he said, like, my kids stopped playing with chalk years ago. But I can see he still has an interest in it if he wants to be out there doing it.
Take on it, they pay him another
one. Well, that's the spirit, I guess.
Yeah, people want to know, this isn't my question, I'm on video, I assume. People want to know why you guys are so stupid. Do you have a, that's not me asking, I know why, but citizens are saying, why do they do this? Why are they so immature?
What's going on, buddy?
Not much. Huh?
Where are all your people at?
Oh, we're out and about, you know.
I was hoping to talk to y'all at once, but...
Oh, yeah, I am recording audio and video, just so you know.
The reason I wanted to talk to y'all...
Please don't touch my bike, ma'am.
I'm sorry.
The reason I wanted to talk to y'all is, we hear, but I don't necessarily know, that some people, maybe not you, but some people in your group, or maybe people unknown, are taking the chalk off the tires when the parking people put the chalk on.
Uh-huh.
I'm just giving you... So, I'll give you a copy. I'll read along with you if you want.
Okay.
When the marking people put the chalk on, you know, they're marking a time, and in essence, they're starting an investigation, so to speak. So if someone removed that, it's a Class B felony, right?
Mm-hmm.
So my hope was to talk to more than just one at a time to explain that, you know, if you want to go and put coins in the meter and walk around, that's all up to you. But once you start taking the chalk off the cars, you're committing a felony. And the definition under 641:12 is on the other side. I highlighted it. You know, it's under the perjury thing, but that's just where it's.
What is this RSA, if I might ask?
Right there, falsifying physical evidence, right? You talking about the one that it references? Right here? See, I highlighted it, 641:12. That defines official proceeding.
Mm-hmm.
It just happens to be under the perjury. It's not part of just where the definition is. So, take a read on that. You know, if any of your other compadres want to talk to me, they certainly can.
Hello.
Hi. The reason I came to see you is I understand that you filmed one of the janitors who was cleaning off the chalking that was done over on the ramp.
Earlier today?
Yes, yeah.
Gentleman was just trying to sweep that off. Wasn't working very well.
Do you know who put the chalk in there?
I might. Do you have something you'd like
tell
me to relate to them?
Can you tell me? What's it going to cost me? He said, you might tell me, so what's it going to cost me for you to tell me who put it there?
He said,
you might know, so. I mean, I'm not going to pull it out of you. I mean, what do I have to give you to relinquish for you to tell me who did it?
Well, I might not know specifically who did it, but I could relay a message to them if you'd like. If
you would, please. Thank you. And from what I understand, your name is Garret, correct?
Mm-hmm. I'm Garret, yes.
Okay. Are you at liberty to give me your last name?
Ian.
Your last name is?
Ian.
Spell it.
E-A-N.
E-A-N. That's a name you've adopted, or that's your given name?
Well, from what I understand, adopting names is pretty common around here, but I happen to be born with it.
E-A-N. Okay. All right. Any questions for me?
Well, none. Do you have a message to relay for the person of the shop?
Well, here's the reason I'm asking. From the city attorney,
mm-hmm.
My understanding is that one is within its legal bounds to chalk sidewalks and stuff on the ground. Not to do that to walls. So, and why? I don't know. This is the same material, isn't it, as that.
Right.
But, so, the walls should not have been chalked. And I understand that, again, that you were there as a man removed it. And no one's pointing a finger at you. Because I said to the janitor, I said, well, can't say Garrett did it. Garrett merely watched you remove it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just wondering as to who did it. It's not the crime of the century. I just like to advise him or her or them that, you know, you must refrain from doing the walls.
Right? Okay, I'll pass that along.
And he said there was nothing profane or objectionable about it. It's just that it's not supposed to be there. Right?
All right, thanks.
Thank you, Garrett. Okay, thank you.
CC.FPP.
Did you want it?
Are you going to edit this for me?
No bear cat. No bear cat.
Are you going to edit this for me?
Do you know if the Keene Police Department has another clear camera other than the one on the Bearcat?
I'm not sure. I don't think so.
No, I've lost my life a couple of times.
So what do you think? Because I'm thinking there's probably a lot of instances in which people scatter from parties, run into the woods.
We wouldn't use a FLIR for that.
That's good to hear.
You're all safe. Next time you run, you're safe.
I mean, I'm over the age of 21. I don't gotta worry, but I know underage people had very dangerous experiences because they've run from the police when a party's getting broken up, go stumbling through the woods.
I don't know why they do that, because most of the time we're just there to stop the party. If you choose to run through the woods, that's on you, right?
Gotta be careful.
You gotta be careful.
In this video, AKPF is environmentally friendly.
As you notice, there's a crosswalk here, but there's no traffic that actually interacts with this intersection because, I mean, you can turn left or right out of here, but people push this button and then the crosswalk gets activated and all these people have to stop. So one thing I've talked to the enforcers about is maybe waiting until the traffic passes and not using the button system and instead just trying to cross on their own when it's safe. Just like I believe it'll be after this cruiser or Crown Vic or whatever, what's it called? PT Cruiser comes by. You know, we just gotta wait for, well, there's another blue car coming too, but. See? No button needed to be pushed. Well, these people are stopping just because they can, I guess. They could have just zoomed right by. You don't need to push the buttons. You don't need to waste people's gas. Sometimes I think they'll push the button just out of spite, like, I'm gonna make them stop. But I like to try and be courteous to the people that are in those cars. Hey, Garret here. It's about 1:40, May 18th, 2013, and we are having lunch in the park today. We are at Robin Hood Park in Keene, New Hampshire. And in solidarity with X, the rapper that was arrested for drinking iced tea outside of a liquor store in North Carolina, I bought a tea and lemonade piece tea. Now, they had the Arizona tea that he was actually drinking when he got arrested after he was barked orders at by some undercover cop, some very bully-like individual. And so in solidarity with him, I bought this one. Now, I would have gotten the actual Arizona iced tea that he had bought when we got our lunch at the Beaver Street Market, but I didn't want to be supporting the Arizona Corporation because of SB 1070. It's a very anti-immigrant, I think anti-human piece of legislation that was put forward in Arizona. So I got this tea and lemonade combination by Peace Tea instead. But I wasn't really feeling iced tea and lemonade right now, so I also got this lemonade Arnold Palmer. It's a mango flavor. I really like mango. And this segment has been brought to you by CC.FPP.
They just catch me out here sipping on this motherfucking Arizona and shit. You know what I'm saying? Just kicking it, waiting for my nigga more to come through. Shoot this TTT.
Can't pull it up. Where
we
at? He was right behind him, man.
That wasn't him?
Saw, but that wasn't him.
Word. Get puzzle out.
Hey, sir.
Huh?
Great.
Sweet tea, pink lemonade. Who is you?
Homies.
Okay. You see what I'm drinking?
Let me look at it.
You is looking at it. I'm not breaking no laws.
Yeah, that's an invasion of privacy, but
yeah,
I got
it
on camera.
You don't gotta touch me.
Like, read the ingredients.
Read it.
Ingredients.
No, matter of fact, look and see what it is.
You don't even know if he's really a cop.
He ain't show me no identification for no reason.
Big property. You got 5 seconds.
For what?
Yeah, for what though? What's the crime?
We got the camera.
What's the crime?
Trespassing. He's the property.
He's a civilian as a customer.
Why not?
Oh, what?
I ain't break no law.
No, I'm in here 12 use yo.
Well, shot town south side. I'm telling you, I'm day 20. I don't know who these guys are, but I'm saying they're bad. If you got
me, you don't
need
them. Badge number.
He needs a
DJ. We got the camera. Where your badge number?
Put your hands up against the car now.
Put your hands behind your back, sir.
This is an Arizona iced tea. I want anybody to see this.
Yo, he can drink the contents.
Half and half Arizona iced tea.
Trespassing,
sir.
For what? I'm about to go to the store.
Put your left hand behind your back.
I got it all on camera. He locked this man up for nothing, man. For nothing. He thought that was the alcohol. So he didn't do nothing wrong. He didn't do nothing wrong to leave the property. As a civilian, he has a right to purchase something as a customer if he didn't break a crime. You asked him to leave based on the assumption that that was alcohol, but you were wrong. So he didn't commit no crime. Yo, a lawyer gonna eat this up. Who? What did I do?
Leave the property now.
I tell you what, I'ma leave. I ain't about to go get locked up. I don't live out here. But my lawyer will be eating this up. My lawyer gonna eat this shit up. I'm leaving. You see me leaving. I could talk, but I'm leaving. All right, I could talk, motherfucker, freedom of speech.
I thought y'all niggas was filming the joint. He played the shit out of that, son.
He tried to act like the fucking Arizona iced tea was a alcoholic beverage.
Yeah.
Did you saw the whole shit?
I got up because I thought y'all niggas was filming and I saw y'all. I'm like, yo,
you was making them tight. You making them tight? Wow.
This is, goes back to a 2007 incident.
Right now?
Am I required to answer your question?
Well,
that's exactly what my question is about.
Okay, that's me confronting and questioning a Homeland Security guy back around October 2012. I got criticized for shooting this video because, in the comments section, I got criticized because I was questioning this guy about something that happened, obviously, in 2007. People said, I can't believe you're bringing up that old stuff, or, you know, talking about blah, blah, blah. You shouldn't be talking about the old stuff. It's not, you know, he can't go back in the time machine and fix what he did.
I saw you do this to a mainstream press reporter when he was on near the steps or on the steps of the courthouse in Concord. You told him he couldn't take your picture and so forth. Why did you do
no,
that?
You could take my picture, it's if everyone right, but it's my option if I want to be on camera and answer questions like right now, which I don't.
Dredging up stuff from the past, blah, 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 that kind of thing. I'm sorry, I should probably go and find the exact quote. Maybe later I will, but and if I do, I'll insert it at this point in the video. Anyway, we did destroy the world, but that was last month. Why reopen old wounds? So that kind of mentality. Well, okay, here's my response to that. As a movement, we should have long memories. And the longer our memories are, the more people will want to not bother us. I can't remember which great, I think it was probably a Roman historian or someone along those lines, maybe Herodotus, I'm not sure, but the quote was, make war on the women have too long memories, unquote. Now, of course, we're not waging war, but we also don't want people to wage war against us. And one way to do that is to be true to that quote and make it apply to us, just as it applies to women. Who knows how many women over the centuries were saved by that one sentence? And who knows how many of us will be saved by people being afraid of our long memories. Now, within the context of this idea, it's very important to be forgiving of people who repent of something they did a long time ago. People are more likely to be sorry for something they did 10 years ago than something they did 5 days ago. So there's a place there for forgiveness. And maybe even a little bit of forgiveness once someone has apologized. But we should be doing more of this, not less, this questioning people for things they did a long time ago. They should have to, once a police officer has made an inappropriate arrest of a Free Stater, he should have to worry for the next 10 or 20 years that someone's going to walk up to him with a video camera and ask him about it, and he's going to have to explain himself. Again, with the exception of those who apologize, and repent of their ways, that's a little different. But anyway, just a thought. Long memories, history, good stuff.
We now cut to a very special newscast submitted by Vigilant Christian Mario.
Hey everyone, you're here with the Vigilant Christian Mario, and you're here for another edition of Illuminati Media Expose. In today's video, we're going to talk about the recent breakdown experienced and highly publicized by the media of Amanda Bynes. So, if you haven't heard about it, apparently she's had a mental breakdown, she's been caught with drugs, and displaying all sorts of mental imbalances, and going a bit on the crazy side. So the media is putting this out to everyone, here's another starlet, who's living in Hollywood and can't deal with the temptation and the pressures, and she's just breaking down. Now, are we going to believe the media? Are we going to allow them to just tell us a story and not really look deeper into it to see if this is actually something way more sinister that's actually going on? Because we see this trend happening all the time, okay? And if you're familiar with my work, you do know I've talked about the MKUltra mind control program that the elite are utilizing in the music industry to control and to create an undetectable mind control slave out of the artists so that they can utilize the artists to the fullest capability of pushing that person, that puppet, to do things that they would normally not do, to influence culture in a very negative way. So if that was just Chinese to you, it's because you do need to go back to my channel and go and look at my videos on the MKUltra program. I'll talk about it a little bit further in this video, but you do need to have a foundation to understand what's really happening with these artists, why it is that they're having all these breakdowns. Because, like I said, the media wants you to believe that, she's just crazy. Britney Spears, Amanda, all these people, they're just nuts. They just keep breaking down. What they're not talking about is the actual reason that these actors and entertainers are breaking down. You've seen it all the time. Anna Nicole Smith, it was on TMZ, going around dressed up as a clown, completely non-coherent, obviously drugged up, under some type of control. You even hear the handlers in the background. It's very creepy, okay? This is what we're seeing here is mind control, a program, a very complex program. So just to give you a little bit about that program, it's an MKUltra mind control program, and how it's administered to them is through torture. So they torture the individual to the point that they create so much pain that that person will then disassociate from reality, and then they can implement different types of personality, and this is done through pain, torture, drug, electroshock therapy, and different things. This is a program that was initiated by the CIA in the early, I think, 1960s and 70s. They utilized LSD to see the potential it had for mind control. Now, this government program, this secret government program, has not gone away. In fact, they've been developing it and perfecting it over the last several decades to make it what it is today, so that they can have completely undetectable mind control slaves. And that's what we see through the music artists. And if you look at Katy Perry's video, Wide Awake, we see this. Like, what does this even have to do with art? art or creativity. She's sitting there in a wheelchair. She looks completely drugged out. There's, you know, she's obviously in a very dark place right now. Some creepy Nazi underground hospital being tested by all these weird sciences. That's what it is, because this is putting out in plain sight what is actually occurring, which is a real mind control program. And you see this again in Nicki Minaj and B.O.B.'s video for Out of Your Mind, which I've exposed. You know, they're in straitjackets, they're in these halls, and they're getting what you can see is satanically tormented to administer this type of mind control to them. You know, you even see B.O.B. at one point resisting it. He's like, no, I don't want my mind control. I don't want the electroshock therapy, because they're trying to break away. So what we're actually seeing here is MKUltra mind control victims trying to break away from the handling and the controlling of the powerful groups, the cults that run the music industry. Okay, so I'm going to do a video in the future really going into Britney Spears. I think she's the most obvious victim of the MKUltra mind control program in Hollywood, in the entertainment industry. And by looking at her life and the events that have happened without the influence of the popular media's opinion on it, we can see very clearly here that there is something very sick and twisted that it is occurring in the entertainment industry. And I've talked about it. It's MKUltra. It's to use these people in horrific ways. So again, we need to be praying for these people. They are basically being used as complete puppets. You know, they've given over their will. They've signed away their soul to be a part of this evil, evil system that God wants to expose to the world, so that we can pray for them and that people will not be influenced by this media. So this is the Vigilant Christian saying God bless each and every one of you. And in times of spiritual confusion and mind control, stay vigilant.
Is this stuffed banana with dreadlocks?
Have you been following Alan's lead in wiping the chalk away?
No, I don't waste my time with that.
That's good. Alan called it a childish game.
It is.
Well, if I thought that he thought it was childish and I was him, then I would think he'd do what you're doing and ignore it. Rather than, like, care about it, you know? Just let it be part of the environment.
I'm in City Hall.
Me?
Are you college educated?
Yes.
I don't know how you spell amendment or speech.
Oh, that was an abbreviation. I took the vowels out. I spelled speech properly. S-P-E-E-C-H. Amendment, though, I took the vowels out on purpose. I didn't know if I spelled worshippers right, if there were two P's in worshippers, because I wrote First Amendment for paper worshippers.